Okay, so I am going to make a statement to the BBC that they can use written and recorded, and this is it, 8th of September 2022. I could also read it out on camera. I'm just making sure that everything is down, and they can then question me on anything I've written. Okay, I'm aware of the ongoing High Court cases suing Rupert Murdoch, most of which are now completed. I met with News International lawyers in 2018 to go over each invoice and each story I was commissioned on from 2002 to 2009. We ascertained in these meetings that nothing illegal was carried out during that time I was involved in journalistic investigations. I have since been told by Hacktoff, Graham Johnson, that all things involving lying are illegal. I had absolutely no idea of that. I now ask that the police be thus informed if they believe any crime has taken place and that I be charged for lying. I certainly have a lot of tales to tell on journalists lying, so perhaps there will be mass arrests. Note well, I was interviewed by Operation Wheating after Clive Goodman informed Wheating I had brought in the phone hacking to News International. Incorrect. I had brought in John Boyle, who brought in phone hacking. I sat for 6 hours with Operation Wheating at my tennis club in 2011, the Hogarth. They asked me, did I want to go under police protection due to the death of Sean Hoare. I was then minded weekly by DS Michael White until the court hearing. However, the accused, including Greg Miskiw, pleaded guilty, so I was no longer needed as no trial took place. I was eager to go to court re Sienna Miller and others, but sadly I did not get the chance when Rupert settled out of court and I was the fall guy to protect Rebecca Brooks to cover up where the info actually came from. Let me please add that during this period of working for The Sun on a full-time basis, I acted and worked as a journalist employed by The Sun, not a PI. I just returned from Belfast, where I also worked as a full-time journalist for the Sunday Times and was much bylined on stories on John White, UDA, and the Real IRA, all front page, all bylined. I consider myself a journalist, no longer a private investigator. I am part of the union and hold a full press pass, except whilst working for the Daily Mail when it was in that capacity as a PI, as this was an ongoing relationship since the late 90s. It was my aim to work as a journalist and not ever return to private investigations. I later published and became a Sunday Times best-selling author with Hodder and Stoughton. In 2002, after I returned to London pregnant, I was dismayed to be given work that included finding out if such and such was in a hospital or to check this or that celebrity or politician was having an operation, or this or that celebrity was pregnant. This was left over from Greg Miskiw, who once asked me to find out if Cheryl Cole had a boob job. I did not do this, as I know calls are recorded to such places, but decided to tell him that I had. I was in the newsroom offices and had been out all day with Mazza Mahmood and felt overworked and abused. Miskiw then gave me other work of that ilk to do, which I responded by using the same method. Under duress and disgusted, but wanting to keep my job, I would either not do anything or ring friends or relatives, and of course, as is my right, to ring a hospital, but not go through to a ward where one has to be a relative. This was easy, as they always knew the info and I was a box ticker. When it began at The Sun, I refused at first and was respected and given true work, as much as a tabloid can have true journalism. Later, by two male editors, I was threatened that if I didn't do this purient work, prying into the personal health lives, I would not be given work at all. I then made a decision I should not have to carry on lying about it. However, I was a new and single mother at this point of a newborn at the time, going through a breakdown as my partner had gone off with another woman. I was receiving treatment at the Priory and was bullied to also spy there by the two editors of The Sun. The only way I could support myself and my son by getting the work we needed was to not carry out what they asked, but pretend to do so. This was quite easy, as they already had these very personal records. I was a mere box ticker. Of course, there are emails and invoices saying this or that, as I kept up an ongoing pretense. I often embroidered on this when asked to do sweeps, etc. I got to the desperate point where I was terrified of losing them, as life with a newborn and just me overwhelmed me, hence why I was at the Priory to deal also with the rejection and loss of love. Loss of a lover, I think, would go in there better. In retrospect, I should have stood up to the bullying and took the risk of unemployment. Yet it is easy to look back now and say this would have been easy. Due to my depression and anxious state of mind, it would have been far from easy. I felt as if I was clinging to the edge of a cliff. I had no support, no family or friends. No family, no friends. Just me and my baby and the fear of going mad. I desperately needed that money. I at no time got any details they did not have. They asked me to stand up stuff only. When they asked for this, I either pretended I was searching for it or made it up. I have full proof of this as a matter of record with my doctor, Mark Collins, as at the time I told him the stress I was under and the bullying. He told me to carry on making it up as I needed money to go there to see him. I was also suffering from chronic hypochondria. I knew boys in care were raped and I feared if I got sick or died, my son would be attacked by paedophiles. So it developed into serious hypochondria and I had no room in my mind to make sound decisions around my bullying by my employers. I was able to give my son a happy life due to the work from the son. I remain grateful to God for it. At least he had a good childhood. It seems now I have to pay for it, but the only one I have done wrong to is Rupert Murdoch. I was under pressure and scared, and on one visit to the Priory, Nick Parker came outside to order me to go in and spy on my appointment with my child in my arms. He said the baby was a good prop. I reported to Dr. Collins that I believe Nick Parker was going to come to my home to force me and my son to perform oral sex on him. Matter of record. This is the amount of fear I felt and duress at the time. I, of course, understood that this went back to my own time in an adoptive home where I was forced to perform oral sex on my adoptive father, been beaten by my mother. In 2016, I got a call off Graham Johnson. I came forward to Graham Johnson, next peer from the Sunday Mirror, to try to help. I told him I worked for the Sun and the Mail. He did not know this and cordially admitted this and thanked me. I then tried to help him as I liked him. The road was rocky, but the relationship has stayed in place. They twittered that thanks to Chris Hart, Sienna Miller got her payoff. I have record of that. I was upset to see Sienna had said I spoke to her GP. I did not do this. Brooks had asked me to check a pregnancy termination. I did not do this. I assumed it's for blackmail. As a very experienced PI since age 16, employed by ex-CID and ex-MI6 officers, I know that it is custodial to data thief. Also, calls to hospitals or GP surgeries are all recorded. That means it is a data theft, which covers... It is data theft, which carries a custodial penalty. I am not Mulcair. Mulcair was not a private eye. I have been a PI since age 19. Contrary to the lies by Tina Brown in the Palace Papers, I work for ex-CID and ex-MI5 and ex-MI6, not sleazy London agencies. Who is controlling this narrative? I realised I was stupid to deal with bullying such a way, and in normal circumstances I might have been more honest with my employers, but the Sun was all I had at the time and I believed a continuation in my career as a journalist to work for them. I'm not the only journalist that would lie to their bosses. This was rife. News International was a criminal organisation, and so, like working for gangsters, you cannot be straight, and I had no one to speak to. Read the bullying by... by senior male staff. I asked Operation Weeting was due to be a star witness in court. I have been interviewed by the BBC and other documentary makers. The lies by News International and Miller to protect the real culprit has affected me. I have not received any work since this has been online. I have not been able to find work and was evicted in 2018. I believe I've now suffered enough for my mistake. I came into training as a private investigator out of a children's care home, had been adopted out of an earlier care home, was returned to one after abuse from my adoptive mother and sexual abuse from my so-called father. I'm committed to helping find out how and where they got such personal data and have my ideas who this is. I fully informed Operation Weeting about this, and it is my former boss. It is also the boss of More Care. I fully apologise to Rupert Murdoch for taking money off of him and not doing what I was asked. I did this as I felt used, asked to be sexual with one of his henchmen, Greg Miskew, using me for sex, non-penetrative but sex all the time. I'd already been used for sex by Philip Hall when he ruined my life in the late 80s in a story that is far, far worse than anything Sienna Miller has to tolerate from the press. It desecrated my life and meant I did not marry, yet no one has offered me compensation. After Hall did that and used me for sex, then dumped me in a brothel, I suffer from further post-traumatic stress disorder. No reparations have ever been made. I believe you have that front page and hope you show it. Hall will no doubt say that I did not. Paul will no doubt make excuses. MB, if I was a journo and a young girl said they were Ian Brady's daughter, I'd seek proof. If I found none, I would gather they were ill. I was dealing with my child rape by going to see Ian Brady. I would not have written they had claimed they were the child of a serial killer, and I would not then take them to France to bonk them. But that's just me. I post a picture of how I looked then. Lots of denials of the men who used me. If one were to believe them, no one would have gone near me. The photograph tells its own story. I was systematically used on Fleet Street for my looks, mostly by Phil Hall. I was pimped out. I was tasked to seduce army men. I was tasked to get into cars with rapist killers. I was paid small amounts and so sucked back into lying to them to get my rightful pay through other jobs I couldn't carry out, as they would have meant prison. Dealing with bullying this way was something I learned growing up in care. Evan Harris, bearing witness, is hearsay to what actually went on in this misogynist world. He has no idea of I ask you, could I have sustained in Fleet Street if I was doing such illegalities? In 1998, I was told my phone was tapped. I was involved with the Real IRA. Journalistically, Graham Johnson attended a London Real IRA meeting with me and can vouch. It was then I became involved with the Real IRA. Graham Johnson also knows I developed an obsession with Francine Mackey and tried to target him for sex, but then missed and got the second in command of the Real IRA, which meant better stories. Campbell then gave me comms from his prison cell at Port Leash, which became front page stories for News International. After London, I gave full and unprecedented access to Dundalk. I was sent there frequently, and it would have been lax by MI5 to not listen to my phones Please note the private I excerpt below in cuttings. I was told by John Ross X. Sweeney, who worked for Murdoch, that he had intelligence that my phone's in an apartment was wired for sound. Yet another reason I could not have done illegal things. I was told I was under complete surveillance, which would include bugs in my flat. Which included bugs in my flat, according to John Ross. Whether it's true or not, who knows, but I think it would have been wise for them to do that. You can go a long way on people believing you're doing something you're not. This was not so with the Daily Mail, as I respected the staff and editors. If I was to do something of that nature, I'd find a way round it that I believed was legal. I've tried to help. Hacked off. But those involved want their narratives so you can get more compo for celebrities. This is fine by me, except I'm the fall guy. No one is doing real investigative journalism here. Years after Mulcair, they are still saying he was a PI and his client was News International. He did not get News International as a client, nor did he have other clients. He worked time for John Boyle. They stole Boyle's office boy. Mulcair. I brought Boyle into News International and unknown to me, he brought in, packing, phone hacking. He told me he worked for The Sun after being pushed out of the News of the World when he stole his office boy. No one mentions Boyle as he is lawyered up. Wheating went to see him but was stopped at the gate by his barrister, stopped to the gate of his £10 million estate by his barrister. Since I'm in knowledge about just how much the info The Sun had, I believe this should be questioned. Rather, it cheaply placed at my door. It is an impossibility to get people's medical records or ring their GP. I believe the information I was given, such as Sienna Miller abortion, was the result of John, who told me he worked for them up to 2019. This doesn't fit the narrative, and it doesn't make me the new Mulcair, which is what is wanted, hoped for. Fact is, no one portrayed the real Mulcair except James Hanning in his book. He was not a PI. Boyle was a PI. I believe Boyle found out the Sienna Miller abortion details. If there was an early story she was pregnant, it wasn't mine. Check the dates. I put pregnancy checks to avoid the word abortion so accounts would not find out gossip. Stupid of me to try and help this lady and not help me. In fact, announced to the press I rang her GP in a possibility. If I ever get money, I'll sue those involved. Let's ask ourselves, how would The Sun and Brooks find out about an abortion? As a PI, I know it's impossible. It's my belief. It was via her phone messages. News International did not use surveillance on anyone unless it's trying to get a pap. Use them as a fool guy as you wish, but as Well, then I go ranting on, and probably I should cut that out about using as a fool guy. I do not live in the same style house as Boyle. Data theme pays very, very handsomely. I live in a rented hovel and last year was made homeless. I totally refuse to be the easy mark and working class fool guy. My own medical records back this all up. So ends. Okay, and there's my cuttings below, and okay, so I'm just gonna insert a photo, and then that is done with lots of spelling mistakes. So okay, that's it. I hope I've done my best.